the second anniversary of the insurgency free status of Davao City, pagpaka na to itong mga polis o sundalo nga nagsakripisyo. Sakripisyo diyaan ang mga lugar kung asa na ay conflict o insurgency before. So, kalawis Ginoo, kadua katuig na nawala na anay samoks tong lugar, ang Bakibato, Marilog, dili perpekto, pero hinay-hinay, nagabangon na niya, karoon po o oportunidad ang mga tao dinhaan ang mga lugar. 911 facilitated healing and reconciliation efforts. So, kani Peace 911 nato, dakog role, which was started by then Mayor and now our Vice President, Inday Sara Duterte. Mo'y nag-cater sa mga naapektuhan aning samok na hitabo sa tuwang katugang panahon. Naputay joint partnership sa ALS, Department of the Education, Davao City Police Office, also enabled 14 former rebels to complete their elementary and junior high education through the ALS. So, nga na kapait ang gubot sa usa ka lugar na iuban maiwit. So, as much as possible, gikan 2 years ago, hantod sa hantod, di na unta na mabalik, o mamantinar na to, nagmakuha na to na basta kita tanang mga Dabawinyo, nagkahiusa ra yun. Mora yun ang puan diha. Crucial kayo. Task Force Davao recorded no terror-related incidents from July 2023 up to the present. Eloise Ginoo, lamat kaayos itong mga TF Davao ng mga sundalo gabantay ito. TF Davao also apprehended illegal drug courier smugglers, suspects in violation of illegal possession of firearms and ammunitions, the Anti-Drunk and Drug Driving Act, and the Anti-Bomb Joke Law. So, this Davao, sagol magita. Permit ko na ginabalik-balik nga storya. I often repeat this because I think this is why Davao City has been successful ever since nagkasinabtanay tantanan nga mutuman yung tagbalaod. Importante kaayo ang disiplina og sense of responsibility with every citizen of Davao City. So every single Dabawenyo, importante kayo ang effort and participation sa pagsadagan sa itong sudad. Dili man nga, kay ako may mayor, magsige na lang kong badlong pod, sige na lang pamantay, magsige na lang kinanglan, ang mismong taga-Dabaw, ang Dabawenyo, na ay disiplina. Aron makabalhin tag mga laing problema aning kalibutanan ni dili nang maglabay kag kalat sa dalan, di na nato na dapat kibaw na mo. Namo sa dalan naatay mga landmark ordinances. Parehan ng anti-smoking, liquor ban, firecracker ban, speed limit. It is up to every Dabawenyo to fulfill their responsibility to the city. Kaya huwag di, magkagubot kita. But, you know, as the city mayor, I know that Dabawen, ang mga taga-Dabaw, mutuman man, buutan mo na mga kuan, buutan mo. Nalay mga bagong tubo, pagkayo kasabot, bata, ng mga teenager, natural. Pero later on, i-guide lang ninyo, kita mga naguna gamay, i-guide lang, bago mga sod, anong dress sa itong dakbayan, ipasabot yun na ito, nga importante ang balaod. Okay, ugwa, either, gok doon kas balaod, bigyan ta ka. Davao City Police, we remain committed to ensuring peace and order stability in the city. Congratulations lang gihapon sa itong mga police. Congratulations na yun. First among all the city and provincial offices of the police regional office. Pero karon medyo naatay sitwasyon lang. I do not know kung unsay epekto ana because it is too early to tell. Sa usa ka adlaw nagkambyo ta og dili ako. Pero ang PNP, ang regional office nila gikambyuhan ng ato city director 3 times without my consultation. So gi-bypass ko ana. Like I said in my previous interviews, then we will have to wait and see kung unsa bay epekto ani. Pero baga ang politika karon. Baga kayo ang politika karon. Lisod, para nako lang. Gani city director na to karon, I want to give him a chance. Kay katungo sa naguna-una man gitubag na nako kanang RD. Pero kani ug maayo nganong dili man pod. Nganong dili man pod. Di man na kuan basta buhato ng trabaho ma-maintain kung unsa ang status ko, which all of us ganahan man po ta and satisfied man ta sa current na peace and order situation nato, kung ma-maintain lang to, wala man tayo problema na. I know a lot of you, maybe all of you, feel uncomfortable towards this situation, but like I said, baga kayang politika karon, the national administration, I believe, is intervening with our affairs. Umuna yung anak na siya. So that's something that we have to deal with. But I know, kita mga Dabawin nyo, layo ora kayo na astinae. We are very resilient people. Dili ta basta-basta nga matandog yung unana lang. They may try. Pero I doubt na matandog ta nila. We thank the men and women of the Davao City Police Office and of the 1,422 police auxiliaries hired by the city government for your continued dedication. City government will continue to support you. Excuse me. Karon mo kita sa kuanay panyo, no? The DCPO has nine infrastructure projects, which include, among others, the buildings for Police Station 7, Police Station 9, and Police Station 19. So, gadungag ba kita permente? Pag-abot sa gasto, when it comes to peace and order, wala kita'y problema diha. Task Force Davao successfully completed several projects designed to enhance operational readiness and overall security measures, including the procurement of 6 container vans for the use of detachments, the enhancement of water assets through the procurement of 1 Yamaha outboard engine and the procurement of radio IP system, improving communication, efficiency, and coordination among units. Meanwhile, the construction of an administrative and procurement building and a multipurpose hall, as well as the procurement of a tactical command vehicle, the refresher training for the CAFGU active auxiliary to personnel are ongoing. The success of the city's peace and security status is driven by the strong collaboration among the members of the security cluster, the local government, and the Dabawenos. So, moment on. To conclude, okay man, wala man tayo problema. Kana lang kay wala consultation karon sa kuha. Mo na ang sitwasyon nato karon. Neither the city ang city director ning istorya man. Pero ginahuwat lang nako unsa yang efforts o tan-awo nato kung unsa mo shift bang ato ang datos. Mausab ba, mutaas ba ang krimen o mas mauubos ba maayo? Wa patakibaw. Wato nato. Di ko kakuan eh.